Welcome back to Family Table. I'm Pastor Tim.
I'm Patty.
And today our godly marriage advice comes to us from Proverbs, the 27th chapter, the 9th verse. The heartfelt counsel of a friend is as sweet as perfume and incense.
So friendship is really important to a marriage, but it's one of the easiest things for us to completely lose sight of.
We often hear about the importance of love and faithfulness in marriage, but we sometimes forget about friendship.
Friendship is that thing that makes us feel safe with each other, lets us be able to listen to each other, and to trust each other.
If love is like a seed, friendship would be the root system that goes deep down, really deep into the soil.
It's that thing that bonds two people together.
In the Bible, God recognized that Adam needed a suitable companion. I mean, the animals were simply not able to fill his need. They weren't a suitable match for Adam.
You hear that? Your dog is not enough.
Dang it.
So it wasn't a suitable match. So God created Adam's wife. He put Adam under a deep sleep and removed his rib, one of his ribs.
Right, then using this rib, God created Eve.
The whole thing about this whole story, I am tongue-tied today. So the thing I like most about this story is that God didn't want Adam to be alone.
Right. God knew that it wouldn't be good for Adam to live life in the garden all on his own.
Right. In the simplest term, God wanted him to have a friend who was like him.
So back to our lives. Sometimes life can become so routine that we go into autopilot and forget the tenderness of companionship.
So take stock of the state of your marriage right now. Really be honest with yourselves.
I mean, would you say that you and your spouse are friends?
I know a lot of you answered that question, yes. And many of you have said that, yes, your husband or your wife is your best friend. But is that just an automatic response we've been trained to say as married people, or do you really mean it?
Right. I can't talk or read either. We have ebbs and flows in this area as well.
But the moment that you realize that friendship is missing is the moment you need to become responsibility for... Guys!
You can tell we're doing this later at night because we can no longer speak or read.
It's the moment you become responsible for rebuilding that friendship.
You have to partner with God to begin that rebuilding.
This is off the topic again, but you said the other day we needed outtakes. Well, this whole video
is an outtake.
Is an outtake. Oh, what did you just say?
God's our partner in rebuilding.
Yes, he is. Absolutely. Good thing we could laugh together that we're friends. As beautiful as marriage is, it really takes two people to devote themselves to putting in the work. To do the maintenance, like we talked about.
Right, it just doesn't happen all on its own, although sometimes we wish it really would.
Just like that house cleaning we were talking about the other day.
I still wait for my house to be cleaned. Automatically, of course.
I was going to say, that was rude.
Yeah.
But anyway, but we got to remember that house cleaning and relationships are not the sole responsibility of just one person.
So let's strive to be people who add to our marriages, someone who encourages instead of discourages, and make your spouse your buddy.
My buddy. My buddy.
You're making the dog
My bark. Buddy and me. Sorry. Oh, goodness. Find out what your spouse likes. Join them in activities they find joy in. Really take an interest in your spouse and the things that they are interested in.
You can tell we only have time for one take because this is all in there. So we can pray for our spouse. We can talk to God about our spouse's destiny, their spiritual gifts, the things they need to do in order to do the things that God has put them on earth to do.
Right. When we begin to prioritize the things that are affecting our spouses, their spirit, their soul, their body, we're going to see that our friendship with them will grow even stronger.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed this crazy couples in Christ, and we invite you to pray along with us. Dear Jesus, we know that we have a friend in you.
Help us remember that friendship is important in our marriages.
Make us best friends so that we can continue the intimate bond you started in us.
We know we need your power to do this, so we ask you to be the power that keeps our marriage together.
Amen.
Amen. Sorry, in the middle of the prayer, all I'm doing is in my head singing, "You've got a friend in me."
This is what happens.
You've got a friend in me. Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, I hope you have fun this weekend and Valentine's Day and tomorrow and or 2 days Sunday. From now.
We don't even know what day it is.
Okay. Just bye.
See ya.